Alright, let's do this shit. Let's do this! So you might be wondering, Beagle, why is this the worst map ever made? In any game, not just XCOM, the worst map ever made. I will tell you why.
Roger, Big Sky.
Jesus, let me talk.
Five. Strike one has the green light for deployment.
Thank you. I will tell you why, because this map... I don't like it, that's why it's the worst map ever made. It's kind of like Burger King, how I was saying you have left or right, and neither of them are good options if you get in contact. It's exactly the same concept here. I have to be advancing to live. If I am getting stuck down, I'm probably dying. This map does not like me to advance. I like to advance in hardcover, this map does not like to give it to me. You will see, and this is how you want to plot your assault routes, obviously. You're looking for hardcover to hardcover. We can go here, this is hardcover. Then we can go to this SUV. Then it's halfcover. We can go here. We have to make probably a dash to get to here, but we can. This is hardcover. And then it's half. Doesn't matter where you go, there is just a fucking gulf in the middle of the map where there is no good assault route. So what happens, and it's narrow. It's narrow as hell. Look at this. This is one end. This is the other. This is literally a murder street. This is just a corridor. There is no flanking. There is no concealment. It's a fucking street. The sectoids are laughing it up with their fucking MG42 down here just gunning you down as you try to advance. So, there is no way to hide. You can't sneak up. You are gonna see sectoids about here every fucking time. You're gonna get in a fight and be stuck here, and you're gonna hate yourself, and you're gonna wish that you could just end it all. And luckily for you, most of the time it happens. But, as terrible as it is, and I'm not actually sure if I've ever beaten this map in, like, the 200 hours I played of this game. As terrible as it is, we will make the best of it. So, like I was saying, we gotta make use of either this or this. This is the only hard cover we got. We're gonna have to abuse the hell out of grenades. I wish we had a rocket, that would help a lot to defuse the situation, but we'll make the best of what we got. The assault might help a little, I don't know. This is gonna be tough. Alright, let's move the rooks up first. Not because I want them to die or anything, just because I want them up front where they can do the most damage with grenades. I mean, the assault has a grenade too, but he's least likely to use his because he's more likely to be flanking and shotgunning. With the rookies, their only special ability is the grenade, so the only real cool move they have is run up and grenade something, so you want them at the front because they need to be close to grenade. Jesus Christ, fuck this map. Okay, here we go. So yeah, I mean, the next move you can make from here is prop up people in firing positions in the bus stop, take this dumpster, and then take this SUV, and then I generally try to advance to this SUV, and then I just kind of die at that point, but we'll see how we go. Dear God. This is... I don't know if you can tell, but this is actually horrifying for me. I hate this map. Jesus Christ. Okay, you stay behind. You are gonna move here, and you're not gonna trigger anyone. Good, good. You're gonna move here. Okay. Ready for next move. The reason I did that is it's like I'm always saying, you want everybody to be ready when you're about to make a move that you think will trigger contact. I feel like if I move up to here, it's very possible that I'm gonna trigger a pack. So I want everyone possible to make a good move. And a good move here is, she can now, because she's moved up and she's ready, she can now make it all the way to here, so I can get everyone in position properly. And that is... I don't know if that's what I'm going to do. Let me check. Yeah, fuck it. Let's move her up. Okay, now that's interesting. Oh, I hate this bug. On this map, it seems like it only happens on this map. A sectoid pack will trigger, and it won't tell you. Like, it won't do the advance warning. So, like, they can see me right now, and they will shoot me. And if I had just stood here and no cover, next turn they probably would have run down here. Sorry, I have to use my cursor. They would have run down here and just shot me, and I would have been like, wow, that sucks. And they wouldn't have triggered or anything. So I guess at least I saw it, instead of just getting surprised by it. I guess that's a bonus. But anyway, now I'm going to move all these guys up. Preferably these guys so they can grenade. Oh, bullshit! Fuck! Oh, son of a bitch! Okay, that's great. I guess. Why don't you shoot your teammate? Okay, no, that's good. I guess do that. Yeah, good start to the map. That was my support, wasn't it? Yep, that was... No, that wasn't... Okay, thank God. Yeah, I actually... I probably should have realized that when I was just telling you that. They're already triggered, so of course they can be an Overwatch. How silly of me. Okay, that is not ideal at all. But you know what? Life isn't ideal, and we're just gonna have to make the best of it. Somehow. Fuck. Let's move this guy up. God, I hate this goddamn map. Now, if they wanted to be huge dicks, they would not, if they wanted to be huge dicks, they wouldn't even come down here now. They would just sit up there in their goddamn fortified position, and... Okay, they're attacking a little bit, that's good. Oh, but they still haven't shot me, so they're still on Overwatch. Fuck! At least I have smoke. Now, if I wanted to be risky, I could try and shoot this guy, actually. See, the way I'm going to defuse this is they need to expend their Overwatch on me. So I've got a clear shot. I'm going to run someone up, grenade the mine melder. Oh, that's so risky, but it might work. Yeah, that's all I can really do. Okay, here comes trouble. Okay, good. Still only one goddamn shot. Weren't there three of them, or were there only two? I feel like there's another guy waiting in Overwatch, and I don't like that. Oh, my ass. That is not a flank. I'm so tempted to grenade that fucker. Let's move up. Okay, so we're trying to advance. I think I might have miscounted. I thought there were three, but there might only be two, and that's why I'm not seeing the third move. Because obviously I'm waiting for the third move before I move, because I don't want to get overwatched. The third sectoid move, I mean. I'm not very good at explaining it. But I think it might just be two of them. That was a Scottish guy too, wasn't it? Fuck, I liked him. Okay, car's on fire now. That's bad. Good news is, I can probably frag the fucker if I don't trigger anyone else. Bad news is, how do I know I'm not gonna trigger anyone else? I could move up here, frag the fuck, and then, you know, what if there's a pack up here I trigger, and then I'm stuck out there in the open? That is not something I want to risk. Oh, but I have to, because I can't stay in this goddamn... Fuck!
That is... You know what, that's just interesting, is what that is. I really wish he was over here. Because I want to frag this sectoid, but I'm worried if I move up, I'm gonna trigger a pack over here, and then that's all she wrote. I could fall back. I mean, I could fall back and make them come to me. And you know what, in this scenario, I think I should. I don't think there's any other good move to make. What if I move here? Yeah, he can't flank me if I move there. Okay. I think I know what to do. This plan will work if moving to this one square does not trigger a pack. Let's see. Okay, this might work. Move her over. You go hide. You go hide. Okay, so I'm gonna make the most of this cover. Next turn, we're gonna frag. Goodbye, car. Nice thing is, hopefully this is still full cover and I can use it, but sometimes blowing up the car makes it half. Okay, what do you do, fucker? Oh, please don't be a flank. Woo!
That's good. That is really good. Now I can flank him. Life is good. Life is good. No, it's half cover now, so that's shit. But I can flank him, so that is definitely not shit. The question is how. I'm really worried that moving up here is going to trigger a pack, and then I'm going to be fucked. If I wasn't worried about that, I would just move her right here. But I'm worried that if I trigger the pack, I want to at least have her in half cover. So, yeah, I think that's what I'll do. Please, 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 please. Okay, good. Now please go tell me you can... Yes! Life is going to be alright. We can frag the fucker. Okay, say good fucking bye. Catch. And now we get to finish that little bastard off. Let me just check that I can get the frag. Okay. Worst case, we're gonna frag him to finish it. But I'm hoping I can save a frag by moving this guy up. And rifling him. Let's see. Oh hell, yeah, no, let's do it. Make it happen. Yeah, buddy! Okay. It's worth going over this again, because that was a perfect example of it. I've touched it on an Iron Man Impossible, but, you know, you, the viewer, might never have seen that. When you have... You want to establish control of the situation, is how I play this game. So basically what that means is, I wanted to make sure I could kill him 100% guaranteed if I had to. Grenades never miss, you know, except for, like, a very strange glitch or whatever. But, you know, the gameplay, normally grenades never miss, so I knew if I wanted to, I could throw the second grenade and kill him. That's why it's okay to then bring this guy up, take the risk of a 50% shot, because even if he misses, then I can use the frag to end it. So I have control of the situation, I can end the fight whenever I want. And because I then took that shot, now I've got an extra grenade, which I'm definitely going to need on this piece of shit map. That said, this is probably the furthest I've ever got on this map, this early in the campaign, believe it or not. I usually die back here. So we might actually... We might be okay. Fingers crossed. Knock on wood. Hello. I wonder if they are also already triggered. That would be really annoying. I am willing to sit in half cover to find out if he comes and shits on me. It sounds like there's a third sector up there who's triggered. I don't really want to fuck with him. So let's hide. Hidey, hidey, hide. I mean, if there wasn't an enemy I was worried about, I would just move them up however I liked. But I'm pretty sure he's active and he's gonna shoot me, so let's... Yeah, he's fucking active.
They're trying to pull back.
What the hell's going on? Okay. We couldn't see it because we were hunkered down, so our vision is lowered, but we could still hear it. So that's how we saw the you know, that's how we hear it. We heard that he moved, then he moved back, Aliens and XCOM both, you only get two moves, you know, the first move and then the dash. So we know he's not on Overwatch because he moved twice. So we are safe to move up now. How far we move up is up to us. I'm probably going to take it very carefully still. Because I'm worried about triggering more packs. My eventual goal is hitting this hardcover truck. If I can get to this truck without dying, I can probably win the mission. It's a big if though. I am always another pack away from being totally fucked. So we're just going to keep using half cover, using hunker down to make the most of half cover to advance. Okay, now that was a one move. That's kind of scary. But let's just keep creeping up little by little. And one day we'll get there. I am kind of scared to move this guy up because he could come around the right side and flank me. So I'm actually just going to leave him here. He can cover with smoke if he has to. Okay, let's... Oh god. What is he doing?
Shh. I think I heard something.
Please don't be more. I only want one sectoid.
They're falling back.
Okay, no, still only one sectoid. I'm pretty sure this is the only guy. I don't think he can be on Overwatch. I'm pretty sure he moved twice. Fuck yo shit! Wait, Okay. You see, I was about to just take the shot, but you've got to be more careful than that. And I'm thinking, 70% is good, but what if it doesn't kill him, or what if it misses? And here's the thing. If it doesn't kill him or it doesn't misses, this guy is stuck in half cover, and then he needs to, he's kind of fucked, because this guy's going to shoot, he's in half cover, he's probably going to die. So obviously my next move would be to move one of these guys over and flank. Problem with that is, what if moving here triggers a pack, and then I have to worry about that. This is why I probably want to make this move first, leave this guy to react. If I trigger a pack, maybe I'll hunker down. I don't know. It really depends. No, you know what? At this range, I'm still gonna... It doesn't matter. I'm still gonna take the shot, so let's take the shot. Fucking balls. The only thing is, this just makes it harder if I don't want to flank. And a little bit of me is actually scared that he could be on Overwatch and there's like two of them. I don't know. I'm a little bit scared. God, I don't know. Part of me wants to just sit here, take a really shitty shot, and then not possibly draw Overwatch. I'm not sure. What if I move down here? Oh, it's difficult. What if I pull the shotgun? Ah, it's still shitty. I mean, worst case, I could frag him, but I need that frag. God, it's really unlikely for there to be sectoids there. I think I just have to run up and do it. But I am so fucked if it doesn't work. Ah, fuck it. Oh, Jesus Christ! Okay. I think I'm good. Okay, I think by, like, a one tile, I think I'm good. That's really scary. But that happens, I guess. I am a little bit scared that if I take a shot, they're gonna see me. But I don't think it works like that in this case, and I'm pretty willing to assume it doesn't work like that. Good kill. Please don't activate, please don't activate, please don't activate. Yes! My faith was not misspent. Okay, so that worked. A little bit of luck on not triggering the sectoids. I can't believe they fit a pack of goddamn sectoids in that tiny little corner of the map. But I'm glad they did. I'm glad they weren't here. I'm glad they went a tile closer. So this, like I was saying in Mission 1, this is the paranoid game of trying not to trigger the sectoids you know are out there. Because I would have been fucked if they had shot me in that turn that I was trying to kill this thing. Hopefully I'll be okay now though, because now I have the truck to use as hard cover. And I can get into a bit easier of a fight with them. I actually, you very rarely want to split your forces like this because you want to keep everyone together and strong. But I think I'm going to send this guy around here and split him simply because I'm going to make contact. I'm going to be up against these hardcover walls. Hardcover is good, but it's not everything. We're still going to have the flank. So if I make contact here with these two, this guy can be on the flank. They're going to see us go, oh shit, run to this taxi, run to here. Boom, this guy's got perfect flank. So I think that's what I'm going to do. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. And until such time, I do not want to make any crazy moves. Oh yeah, and people always ask this. I should have mentioned that. The reason I switched to my pistol is, you have unlimited ammo for the pistol, but you have limited ammo for your rifle. I don't know why people always ask me this, it seems like common sense to me. But basically, there is no difference between the accuracy of your pistol or your rifle. The only difference is the damage. The pistol does less damage. So if the enemy only needs one bit of health taken off to kill them, you may as well use your pistol, and then you don't have to reload your rifle's ammo. Reloading can be really inconvenient. You know, it seems like you have a lot of ammo, but you will get to a turn and you'll be like, shit, I have no rifle ammo. Now that move I could have made is fucked. You will see me use the rifle sometimes anyway, like in the first mission, because the rifle does more environmental damage, which is what makes cars blow up and walls damage. So if I want to blow up a car, I will still use the rifle. But otherwise, you know, you may as well use the pistol because you're saving ammo. And it's kind of a tangent because I should have said it back then, but I remembered and people keep asking. So that is why I use the pistol. And next time I'll say it in more detail next time it happens. It'll make more sense. But anyway, yeah, the turn I was having, sorry. Speaking of reloading. Okay, interesting. Here we go. I guess them coming to us is good, because I get a free Overwatch shot. Yeah, this works out decently. Oh, yeah, it does. Oh, yes! I knew believing in Sweden or Norway or whatever would pay off. Oh, that's not good, though. Okay, bad news, we just triggered 4 sectoids at once. Or 5 and we killed one. Good news, that is probably all the aliens on the map. That is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ooh, there could be 10. We'll see. But what's important now I'm in contact, so now I have to get in cover. I really hope that guy gets the flank I'm hoping he gets. And now we have to, get in cover, so let's do it. We can't fuck around anymore. She needs to get in good cover. Like, I'm not comfortable with her being on the corner. She'll get sniped. She needs to be in really good cover.
Overwatch. Aye, aye.
And you, my friend, need to go and hunker down. Obviously, I'm hunkering this guy down because on the corner he can be shot. I don't have to worry about dashing these guys or hunkering them down because this is concealment. They can't be shot. There is no corner to peek around. So that's why I'm not worried, obviously. Concealment is always better than cover. If you can't be shot at all, it's better than being shot at but being unlikely to get hit. So that's why if you can make it so the enemy can't see you in this, it's better than being in good cover. But anyway, that simple battlefield knowledge aside, let's continue. Ooh, that's lucky. It's one of those shots I don't know if I want to take. I mean, it's a good opportunity to kill one, but then again, what if the other three then come out next turn and just no-scope me from across the zone? It could happen. It could very easily happen, and it is scary. What I will do is check what's on... Ooh. I'm gonna check what's on this side. Okay, nothing. Interesting. It is a 60% chance to take one of them out of the game right now. That's nothing to smirk about, but at the same time, I feel like it would be... It is still a risk. It looks really good on paper, but it's still a... it's still a 35%... Or it's still a 40% chance of failure, and that is nothing to smirk about. So I'm going to hunker down. And because now they're visible, I'm going to hunker them down as well, obviously. I mean, I just said it's better to put them back in cover and put them back in concealment. But the thing is here, I want to keep tabs on these guys, so I have to stay on the corner because I want to see them. Hunker down's very safe. It's possible I'll die, but it's very, very unlikely. And it's worth it so I can keep tabs on them and see where they... Holy shit, are you kidding me? They were hiding in the fucking truck? Wow! Wow, I'm fucked. A fucking moving truck full of sectoids! Are you kidding me? Great! Awesome! Excellent. Okay, that's cool. Okay. Never... You know what? I have not seen the sectoid truck before. That's an interesting strategy. I'll keep that in mind. That really fucks my day up. I'm not gonna lie. Not entirely sure what I'm gonna do now. Whatever happens, I need to kill this thing. Always check your rifle. I almost shot him with a pistol. I really need to get some kills now. We are really fucked. Yay! That's what I need to see. Still leaves me in a bit of a pickle. Yes, it does leave me in a bit of a pickle. Here's the thing. I would like nothing more than to just sit and cover here. But this guy can move to this corner in his turn easily. So I can't leave this corner. Because if I leave this corner, he's going to run down here and he's going to get a flank shot on one of us. I kind of don't want to move this guy here. Because I can't see the sectoids here. And if there is one waiting here, all it has to do is, you know, run around the corner and kill me. So if they're that close, I don't want to move there. But I kind of have to. Oh, and he can get flanked too if the... Oh, shit. This is just a really bad position to be in. I'm just going to make the most of it. I'm going to frag these two. It's not ideal, but I can't really wait for ideal at this point.
Frag out.
Oh, nice throw through the fucking cab. Alright, you know how I was saying, like, you got to take what you can get in situations like this? This shot right here is one of those take what you can get, I think. I don't know. 65 isn't that good, actually. I don't know. He can still run up. That's really scary. I'm gonna hunker down. I just hope he doesn't run up and no-scope me. Ah! Don't do anything stupid. Don't do anything stupid. Oh, good girl! That is nice. Okay, she's panicking, that's bad, but what she did is good. So what do we do now, Beagle? That is a good question. This guy needs to get up in the fight and help. That is for sure. This guy probably needs to make a gigantically risky play and flank. I am terrified of doing that because he could very easily die, but there's not a lot else to do in this position. What I'm thinking is this guy needs to run and gun up to this hardcover, shotgun the dude in the face, be done with it. He is gonna take Overwatch fire is the problem. I guarantee this guy is an Overwatch. This guy probably is an Overwatch. But the thing is, if I don't make a risky move, Halvorsen is dead next turn. I could maybe move him around here, but you know, what the fuck is that going to do? Also, I'd have to run over the roof, and that is a shit idea. Oh, I hate making moves like this. I'm going to move Hassan up and see if he can help, just in case. No, he can't. Fuck. Oh, this is really bad. This is so terrible. I've got to do it. Barat Houseman has to be a fucking hero. Now, here's the thing about drawing Overwatch. When you dash, because you're sprinting, because you're moving faster, you are less likely to be hit when you are dashing. Thing about that is, I'm still quite likely to be hit by the Overwatch, but he's got to fucking do it, so... Oh, Jesus Christ, be a hero. Be a goddamn hero. Oh! Jesus Christ! No! Oh god! No, it's all over! Okay, We're fucked. There is no way around this. We are fucked. Yeah, now I bet you mind merge. Oh god, that's terrible. Oh, Halvorsen, I'm so sorry.
Incoming fire.
Oh my god, she's still alive. Oh my god, she's still alive! Jesus Christ. There is a really risky move I could make here. It's very all or nothing. Oh my god, is it all or nothing, but it could work. Look, I mean... This is one of those moves... I could... Oh, this is so risky. Alright, we know there's three sectoids. I'm pretty sure we killed the other one, I can't remember, but fuck it. Look, we're not in the mood for cautious moves at this point. I'm pretty sure this guy is mind-melding a sector that's sitting right here. This... I could flank her up because they both shot. Like, well, they both took moves. I could flank her up and shoot this guy. But if I do, she's probably going to get overwatched by whoever's here. But... And this is why this is risky, because there's no fucking cover on this goddamn map. But if I run this guy up the edge of the map, I can probably get a flank shot on the Mind Melder, kill him, clear the way, she can move up and kill the Overwatcher. So let's do this goddamn bullshit. Go, you son of a bitch. Oh, Jesus Christ. Why is there more? Oh, God, no! Liv, you goddamn bastard, Liv! Oh, God, why is there always more sectoids? It's all or nothing. Oh, it's nothing.
Shot failed to connect.
Oh God, the horror. The fucking horror. Oh God, come on! This is what my life comes down to. This is XCOM right here. Oh, there's another one. Jesus Christ. Oh, you... Oh! Oh my God! Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh my God! Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Oh, what the fuck? What do I do? What the hell do I do? I don't know what to do. Oh, this is really scary. Is this guy an Overwatch? I didn't even see his move. I don't know what's going on. I really don't know what the fuck to do. I think I have to take this half cover. Oh, no, wait. I see what I can do. I can pull him back in another full. Shoot that fucker, maybe? Maybe shoot that fucker? Oh, but he is... Oh. No, I gotta take the half cover. It's terrible, but I've gotta take the half cover. Let's fucking do this, mate. Right, one sectoid down. Let's do it. Boom.
He's down.
You're dead, mate. Let's drop another tango. Do it. Okay, not doing it. That's pretty bad. Right there, that is not good. Okay, we're scurrying, we're being mischievous. We're probably gonna kill Hassan. Hassan dead. That is... Oh, God in heaven, no. I'm so sorry, Halvorsen. And that is why I hate that goddamn map so much.
Status black confirmed. Return to base for debriefing.
Yeah, that's it's a great map. Got a lot of great cover. Really good features. I'm a big fan of it, if you couldn't tell. Yeah, fantastic. Love those sirens. But seriously, I hate that map. There is no cover and it is a fucking murder street.
If only there was something we could have done.
But that's XCOM, that's the breaks.
That
I could have won if I was a little luckier, or even if I'd... You know, I probably could have made better moves, you know? You can't blame the game too much. But that is that, I guess.
We will be in touch,
Commander. I mean, I'm sure I'll be fine. I haven't lost yet.
Every member of the Council is going to want satellite
cover. It's fine.
So we should plan our deployments carefully. Several members of the Council have expressed some buddies an interest money. In acquiring some of the artifacts we've recovered. However, we should be careful in choosing what items we release.
I don't know, I'm probably a bit fucked.
The research team may not have discovered their true value yet. Commander, we've suffered a number of casualties.
Yeah, I know.
Haven't found suitable replacements yet.
I know we've suffered a number of casualties.
We need to start hiring additional soldiers through the barracks.
I'm still having a hard time grasping what it is.
Jesus Christ, people, please, I just had the worst mission in the world. Stop talking to me!
Are they studying us? Why abduct humans seemingly at random? There must be a pattern that we haven't established yet.
Yeah, great. Okay, they're done now. Anyway, yeah, I am, I'm probably a little bit fucked. You could say that. But you know what? We'll see how we go. I mean, sure, I need $420 that I don't have to make a satellite that I'm going to need so I don't lose in the the second month. But all in all, I mean, could have lost the first mission, so I mean, the campaign isn't going as bad as it could.